welcome you all to Medical Ultrasound Academy. In this type of a talk, I'm going to discuss on what is called a quadriceps tendon rupture. It is not enough to talk about our medical ultrasound practice without mentioning the musculoskeletal ultrasound. Musculoskeletal is one of the areas that is not immune to pathological process. So in this case, here is a 78-year-old female who presented to our department with a painful swollen left knee. And sonographically, you can appreciate what I saw. So this is the suprapatellar space, and you can appreciate that there's free fluid in the suprapatellar bursa. So this is a collection you can see here. But inside the collection, you can appreciate that there is this echogenic flaps of tissue that you are seeing here, and you can see they are here as well. So you can appreciate what is taking place here, free fluid, and this echogenic flaps of tissue that we have here. So this type of an examination is very pertinent because the integrity of the knee joint is also dependent on these tendons, which are called the quadriceps tendons, which actually hold the patella in space, and they can actually confer the stability of the knee joint as well. So you can see here we have is a collection of free fluid in the basal space. So what can collect in the suprapatellar space can be free fluid due to an inflammatory process we call bursitis. It could be hematrosis following an injury to the articular space of the knee joint. So here, this patient has no history of trauma, but it's an old lady. So you can actually appreciate that the ligaments of these old people, at times they can be very frail and fragile, so they can actually break. So on color Doppler interrogation, you can appreciate the collection that we have here. That's the collection, and then we don't see any sign of color flow on Doppler, so there's no flow that you can appreciate in this collection you are seeing here. There's no flow, so this we can rule out bursitis, which is an inflammatory process. With inflammation, we expect to see a hyperperfusion, but in this context, we actually see that there's no perfusion in the case in question. Again, you can appreciate from this end that we can see this flap of tissue that we have here, which I suppose is part of the torn quadriceps tendon that you can see here. So these are the remnants of the tendon which is torn. So you can appreciate what I'm talking about here, and you can see the effusion. So the effusion is actually is a window for us to appreciate this type of flaps that can be remnants of the torn quadriceps tendon. So this is our patella joint, and this is where the attachment is supposed to be. And then you can appreciate that there is a flap of tissue that is consistent or in keeping with the rupture of the tendon. From this end, you can actually appreciate there's a discontinuity here. You can appreciate this tissue or this flap of muscle. Then there's a discontinuity here, and then you see our effusion that is going all the way. So this you can appreciate what I'm talking about. And then also on power Doppler, which is more sensitive than color Doppler, you can appreciate that there's a little bit of perfusion that you can see here. So effectively, there's not much significant flow right around the collection to actually give us an indicator of an inflammatory process. So to me, an inflammatory process was not. So this, I concluded that this is a case of a ruptured quadriceps tendon with a collection of free fluid in the suprapatellar basal space, as you can see here. So this, when you're doing a knee joint scan, you must actually assess the joint spaces to see if there is any sort of collection or effusion or rupture of the tendons that you can might appreciate. We also have to look at the posterior aspect of the knee joint to look for what we call Baker's cyst. MSK is one of the areas that most of you are not conversant of, but it's one of the exciting areas that can also help our communities. When you're an MSK sonographer, it means you can actually be a useful person or healthcare personnel in your community. So you must also develop an interest in MSK ultrasound. I thank you all. I hope you are safe wherever you are. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much.